Here to the centre there, and just draw a line down. So that's where those would have been. Then we get the centre here. So that now goes across. Yeah. And this row of rivets down there, there. So there's going to be one directly there. There's going to be one directly there. So. This has been painted, yeah. Well, that was just on straight fiberglass.
Right.
So now feel that. Yeah. So what you need to do is now top with some fine wet and dry, and that's. So now you feel that, and you don't think there's enough detail, but you're talking in terms of painting. This being microns. What I've got to do now is just get a bead of glue. Centre of that rivet and centre of that rivet. So, just as a guide, draw a line, then the centre of that rivet and the centre of that rivet as a guide. That'll be the one that goes across. So you look at the pitching here, and that one will be roughly there. Look at the pitching, there's one right at the corner there. This one's going to be one there. Get that one in, and then you can roll in, looking at this pitching here, bringing it across. Now that one is not right up to the line there, so there's going to be one pitched either side. You need to rub the top surface with a little bit of wet and dry to take the burrs off, and that's giving you your detail, brought you back your detail over your panel. From that side is because if you're going across and you're trying to match it, the pitching, it's sometimes better to have the slight misalignment in the middle than it is to do with the edge. So that's why you start coming in that way, stopping, and then bring these in.
Right.
And then you can come in with the one before, and you can roughly go to the centre of the two, so it looks like it's better pitching.
And I suppose on the real aircraft, were they all measured perfectly, or were they just...
No.
Did they have a jig to drill, do you know?
No, it was basically what they used to do is used to measure between two frames or two ribs.
Right.
And then the drawing would give you an idea and say 15 rivets between that pitched evenly.
Right.
There was no actual dimension. It's down to the operator.
So it was done by hand. They quite literally.
Yeah,
I didn't realise that.
They used to use dividers and they used to set it up so it all went across. They sometimes used to calculate it and then work it out on a calculator. But usually they did it with little dividers and then measured across
and then just adjust them accordingly.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah.
So rivets would never be perfect.
No.
Even on full size aircraft, if it's hand done. There will be discrepancies. If it's machine done, then of course it'll be perfect.
It'll be perfect. And of course, nothing was perfect, I suppose. No. And of course, on a war machine that's only going to last 2 weeks, time was of the essence to get it out.
They didn't really.
Yeah.
You know, you've got people who would do 17 across the top, and then some do 16 across the top.
Yeah, yeah.
Depending on which one. As long as you had them, there was more, they were more to do with edge clearance. There was always to do with two, it was classed as 2D, which meant two diameters. So the centre of the hole was two diameters of that hole away from the edge of the panel.
Yeah.
And that was a safety margin.
Oh, I see. It stopped cracks.
Pitching was either 2D or 3D. So three diameters or two diameters between each hole. And that's how it was always specified on drawings. And then they would say 17 at 2D, 17 at 3D, 16 at whatever.
Right.
So they gave you an idea so you could roughly work out. If it's an eighth rivet, then it'll be either a quarter inch gap or 3/8 of an inch gap. So.
And I suppose they had a set time to do all these in, so it was rush, get them done, get it.
They're all on peace time, so it was like literally work as fast as you can.
And as I said, they didn't expect the aircraft to last long, so long as it was functional, that's all that mattered.
And one thing with British aircraft is they were always drilled deep panelled and deburred, where a lot of the American rivets or holes were drilled and then reamed.
And right.
I reckon the reaming used to clear the hole of any burrs, but it didn't. So all British aircraft used to be drilled, reamed, dismantled, deburred on the rivet, on the frame, on the skin, and then re-riveted.
All right, thanks for that information.
That's what you get for working at British Aerospace for 16 years.
Yeah, yeah.
So what are you doing here? Phil, these are screws.
These are screw heads, or to simulate screw heads. They're not actually screw heads. These have been custom made out of vinyl.
And they're actually sticky back.
Yeah, it's just sticky back vinyl. And what I'm doing is I'm putting them in the place where a screw would be.
Yeah.
This is the easy part, is putting them on. So I cut around about 2,000 a sheet.
Right.
And then.
Without your glasses?
No. You've got to see where the actual slot is. So it's either a slot or. So either a slot head or a.
Oh, I see, yeah.
Phillips. So, because this is a Russian aeroplane, they literally used to go to a box of bits and not actually know
really
what screws they were getting out, as long as it was the right length.
So they could be Phillips heads or slot heads.
Yep, on Russian aeroplanes they were never, ever. I suppose they were specified, but once the aircraft was in service, they were really not that worried about what was going back, as long as it was, as I say, the same diameter.
And so long as it did the job, I suppose.
Yeah.
And how many screws would this type of aircraft have in all, do you reckon?
I think I've put on here about 300 so far.
Right.
I think it's going to be around about 1,000 screw heads, because all these panels, wing to fuse panels and bits and pieces and all these hatches and everything else, they will have.
They all need doing.
Yeah.
And what about rivets? Any idea of the amount of rivets guesstimating?
There's 5,000 on the nose so far. There's 2,500 on each wing.
What, top and bottom?
Yeah, and there's about 1,000 on the tail plane so far, and about 1,000 on the fin.
And that's rivets.
That's rivets.
Yeah.
But as you know previously, riveting doesn't take that long.
Yeah, that was definitely a surprise.
So
nice to see.
What I'm doing here is putting the fasteners on the access panel, or one of the fairings, I should say, not the access panel, my mistake. So just putting them on evenly.
So fasteners were different to screws, I presume. Were they easy access,
or are these
screws?
These are screws.
All right.
But the Russians weren't really into a thing called Zeus fasteners. And they're sort of like, or another name is cam locks,
where you
would put a screw in and you'd get half a turn.
Yeah,
and it'd lock in.
Yeah.
To a cam. These are screws. There are more on full size aircraft. There are more panels held on with screws than there are cam locks, mainly engine nacelles.
Is there vibration or?
Engine nacelles are more cam locks, or
yeah,
for easy access panels.
Quick access, yeah.
You know, wing to fuse fairings on airlines and everything else are usually screws.
Right. And then once they're stuck on, you've got to remove.
Then I go through the process of removing the centres. And I don't take the centre out until the end, because the centre actually holds it, it's circular.
Oh, I see, yeah.
But I need a light so I can see whereabouts which way this is. So.
Yeah.
Once you, some are good, some come out very easy, and some don't.
I'm having trouble with my focus. That's better. So as you say, if the centres weren't in when you put the decals on, they'd just, would it be a nightmare, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Trying to put two halves on.
Yeah, if we do one here, take that out, and then you pick that side up, you put that on.
Yeah.
And it's starting to distort or move and everything else. More so for the Phillips than those ones. I've got to get a Phillips.
Yeah, because they're a double slot.
They've been. Can you hold that for us? Yeah, so because the backing is so slippery, it's hard to take the centres out. So
it makes sense once you've stuck it on, then support it on the model.
That's it.
And then you say you spray completely over the top of these?
Yeah, you don't have to remove these. These give you that slightly raised screw, like they've been countersunk, but they haven't been countersunk just enough, which normal screws are, because...
Yeah, they've got to be flush.
They sometimes are slightly proud, because what happens is when you do countersunk on some skins, there's a chance of not, it's called knife edging, when actually the countersunk or the angle is greater than the actual thickness. So what actually happens is it cuts through, so the hole in the skin starts to get bigger because you're cutting a
a
countersink in it, and that's called knife edging, which is in the aircraft industry not a good idea.
No.
You know, there's all the. And sometimes what they do later on, once it's painted, is put little black lines to show that they're actually locked. But that's more on cam locks than it is on screws.
And then you know instantly if it's turned and become
undone.